there! I'm Lindsay, and this is Samwise Hamgee. He is a winter white dwarf hamster. He's probably about 4 to 6 months old. I don't really know. I got him late June, so maybe 6 months. Hopefully only 6 months. And this is his new Lord of the Rings inspired Shire Hobbiton hamster cage. And today we're going to show you how I made it. And he wants to go back in. So first, let's put him away. There you go. Bye, Sam. Okay, first things first. This is an IKEA Detolf. It's a glass display case that I put together, and you just don't put the top on, and then it kind of transforms into like a great IKEA, or a great IKEA, a great hamster enclosure. For a dwarf, he can't get out of this cage. It's way too, like, this is enough to where he can't crawl out, but if you had a Syrian can probably get out, so you're probably going to need to build just like a wooden topper for this with mesh lining or something, or maybe just a mesh topper, I don't know. There's a couple different things I've seen people do just to keep them from getting out. But my dwarf, he can't get out, and maybe your dwarf can. You might want to make sure that he can't get out before you do this for any dwarf hamster, but mine's, he sucks at climbing, so he definitely can't get out. I've tried to like help him get out just to make sure that he couldn't get out, and he can't do it, so he's not getting out of here. The bottom lining is aspen, and it's pretty thick. It's probably, I don't know, what's this, 4 to 6 inches all the way across and all the way back, and I kind of made it sloping, so it's kind of like a hill. And underneath this section right here is a plastic tunnel that's like bendable that I got on Amazon, and I'll have links to everything that I bought on my blog, and I'll have a link to the blog in the description below so that you guys can see kind of what I have and where I got it. That way I don't have to stop every time and say where I got these things from. The top is green Carefresh bedding, which probably everyone has heard of. And then I sprinkled in brown as kind of a walkway through it. So it's mostly green with brown, making a little walkway all the way through it. The plants in here are actually from IKEA too. They're IKEA fake plants. And I just bought one of each, so one that was like kind of like this spiky, and then one that looks kind of like a bush. And I ripped all the fake plants out of the little pot. They come out in like little sections like this, and spread them across the cage, and it worked really well for what I was trying to go for. I think even if you're doing like a rainforest cage or something like that, you could probably get away with doing this. And before I used it in this cage, I put one of the plants in his other cage just to see if he would like try to eat it or something. I was kind of worried that maybe he'd eat it and it'd make him sick, but he is absolutely not interested in that, so I don't have to worry about that. I also have a bunch of these little moss balls in here, and they're just like styrofoam balls covered in like a fake moss, and he doesn't try to eat them, but he does have a lot of fun moving them all over the cage because every morning I wake up and he's got moss balls just everywhere. So those are fun. And then near his sand bath, I have some terrarium moss, and he doesn't mess with this either. He doesn't pouch it or anything, but he will come over and mess up the section that I have. I see moss all over the cage, and then just regular rocks around sand bath, which I'll show you in just a second. And the background here is a poster that I cut in half, and I'll talk about more about that later. Okay, over here on the left side of the cage is his sand bath, and for the sand bath I couldn't really find anything, any plastic bin that fit this area very well, so what I did was I got a big black plastic garbage bag and kind of made it like a tarp like you would with an outdoor pond if you're gonna make one outside. And I just use the same principle inside here, and I filled it with chinchilla sand, which he loves rolling around in this, and lined it with a bunch of garden rocks that I had outside. They're nice and flat and smooth, and put the moss in between so you can't see the black plastic liner because it's not that pretty. And like I said, inside we have a brown little walkway that connects all the Hobbit houses in the background with his house. This is an entrance to his house right here, which is kind of covered up right now because he likes covering up his entrances. And then I have a bunch of these little, like, they're fairy garden bags, and this one says salt, some say flour, some say sugar, and they're just like little fake bags. I thought they were cute and kind of added to it. And here's a little wheelbarrow, also fairy garden material. I got that at, I got all of this at Michael's, but I have seen these on Amazon too, so you can definitely find them on Amazon. Like the fence that I used in his main section is from Amazon, which I'll show you in just a second. So let's move over to the fence. Okay, so this is the main Hobbit house section that I made. And this fence right here comes in one long piece I got on Amazon. I think it was, I want to say it was like $7 or something. And I kind of cut it apart and made like a little gate right here and the fence. And then I hand painted some signs for here. So this one says no admittance except on party business. And my handwriting's not that great, but you know, I try. And this is the door to his Hobbit house. And it's like the door to Frodo's house, even though he's Samwise, so we'll just go with it, okay? And it's got the little decoration on the inside, which isn't that great, like I said, I'm not an artist. Right here we have some more of his little foam things that he loves moving around all over the place. This is just a bowl that I use to fill with treats. Right now it's got some like, ooh, some sticky, hard treats that he loves nibbling on, breaking apart. Got some more little bags from IKEA. Here's a little chair, or not from IKEA, this is from Michael's. Little chair from Michael's. This is just a regular hay hut, and then I covered this hay hut in fake grass that I got on Amazon, and I'll have that linked on my blog. And I'll actually show, I have the process, like I blogged the process of this, because this was more of a process than you'd think. I didn't want to use glue because I didn't want to have anything in here that was like toxic to him, so this is all zip tied on there. And then because he's Samwise, and Samwise is a gardener, I've got some little gardening tools that were found in the fairy garden section at, I think, Michael's, maybe Hobby Lobby. And then some more little plants and bags. This says ham end instead of bag end, because he's a ham. And I've got some millet seed spray. He loves millet seed, so his cage always has at least one spray of millet seed in here for him to nibble on whenever he wants. And the front, well, you can't see the front, but there's some plants lining the front just to add some interest to it. Let's see if we can back out right there. We've got some more of the plants, and those are just from IKEA. And then the background, this house behind it, there's a Hobbit house right here, but I covered it up, so this is his like little Hobbit house section over here. And then if we turn, okay, and on the far right is kind of his hammy supply section. We've got his water bottle that I kind of need to get a different one. This one I just kind of made do with it. I made a zip tie around the type and kind of tied it up here. It'd probably look a little better if I got one that suctioned on there, so that's something on my to-do list. And there's just a little fairy garden wall underneath it that he doesn't really use, but I thought looked cute. This is his silent spinner, and it's plenty big for him. He's a dwarf. It's a little cheese block that he eats, not really hobbit-like, but... And there's his food dish, it's over here. This is a little hidey hole that he had in his old cage that he just loves. He loves to bring food in here and eat, so I left it, even though it doesn't really look hobbity, but that's okay. And that is another home on the background. And then over here, this is a little barrel, and we put fresh fruits and veggies in there for him. And I put stuff in there daily. He doesn't eat the whole thing, but I'll put a strawberry or, I don't know, if we have Brussels sprouts, put Brussels sprout in there. I usually give him some greens to nibble on. And like I said, he doesn't really eat it every day. Like, he won't eat all of that, and I'll just replace it the next day since it's such a small amount. And then this is the main entrance that he uses to his little hidey hole. He's asleep in there right now. And this is a little bridge that I was trying to think of the name. This is a little bridge that I have kind of going into his hidey hole, and he uses that to come in and out. And I'll give you guys a better view of that in just a second. And this is his hidey hole, and he's coming out. Oh, well, he was coming out. Samwise! That's the entrance to his hidey hole. As you can see, he can get on out of there pretty easy. And the close-up of his cage. Here he comes. You gonna come out, Samwise? Gonna join us? Well, hi! How was your sleep? You gonna come out and say hi? Hi, Sammy! He says, nah, I don't think I'm coming out. And that's his whole cage. The background to the cage is a print. I actually found a print online of Hobbiton in New Zealand. Somebody went and took a really nice panoramic shot, so I printed it up as a 20 by 30 poster and then cut it in half and added a little bit of extra to one side and put it on the back here. And then I have some LED strips going along the back to light it up, but I really only light it up when I'm kind of out here interacting with him because he doesn't really need the light and it's kind of a waste. But when I'm out, it looks cool. And then I have, up above we have a poster that I thought kind of completed the whole thing. And my no admittance except on party business sign that I use for my wedding. So we keep that up here. All right, and that's his cage. I hope you guys enjoyed looking at the cage. And if you have any questions, ask me in the comments below. I'd love to know what you guys think about this cage. Took me a while to get done. Probably a couple weeks all said, to it's all said and done. I kind of worked on it here and there for the past couple weeks. So let me know what you guys think and subscribe if you want to. Thanks. Bye.